Let's start off this morning looking outside our weather window. This is a look at Alpine proper as that sun's starting to come up about 728, 729 for that sunrise this morning. As we move now to your wind tracker, winds are light in through the region. Those wind speeds will pick up to 10 to 20 mile per hour winds throughout the day today, more on into this evening. And then right now, 27 Pocatello with that light breeze that knocks you down about 10 degrees for a feels like temperature of 17. 24 clear skies in through Idaho Falls with a feels like temperature of 16, still in the single digits, 5 degrees above zero in through Jackson with that light wind that drops you down to -9 degrees for feels like temperature. Temperature tracker around the regions. We're looking at Dubois at 18, Ashton at 10, Jackson at 5, Alpine at 10, out at the site 22 degrees this morning. And in through the region, you can see Salmon at 25, Chalice at 23, Dillon, Montana at 21, Island Park in the single digits, Yellowstone below zero to start off the Wednesday. Storm tracker looking pretty clear right now. We have clear conditions, but as we zoom out, we can see the system coming in off the Pacific, giving us cloudy skies. That's going to be pushing into our region today. We are expecting winds to join those clouds moving in, as we mentioned, 10 to 20 mile per hour winds later today. For tomorrow, your regional high temperature still seasonally below average for 44, the Idaho Falls for, temperature for tomorrow, same for Pocatello. Now, for today though, cloudy skies and windy with daytime highs getting into the 30s and 40s in through the region. As we take a look at the highlands in western Wyoming, we're looking for cloudy conditions. Chance of snow starting up late tonight, extending into Thursday morning. Daytime highs in the 30s for much of the region, just at or a little bit below the freezing mark. Then partly cloudy conditions for the central mountains today. Daytime highs in the 30s, 40s for Salmon and Chalice. Now, moving to the overnight hours, some light snow developing in through the central mountains, mainly in through Chalice area, Salmon area, could be seeing that light snow condition, and in through the highlands in western Wyoming. This is going to be for mainly Island Park and Jackson. Soda Springs should avoid some of those snow flurries overnight tonight into Thursday. Overnight lows in the teens and lower 20s. Then for the Snake River Plain, cloudy conditions overnight tonight. Chance of that snow developing early tomorrow morning, not lasting for very long though. Our overnight lows expected to be 30 for Idaho Falls, 33 for Pocatello. Now as we take a look at your Southeast Idaho Chevy dealer 7-day forecast, cloudy conditions, chance of light rain in the early morning hours, chance of snow on Friday, but look at Saturday. I think it's all worth it if we just get through the next couple days. Beautiful conditions for the weekend. Looks like it's going to be wonderful in through Blackfoot as well, with mostly sunny skies on Saturday. Beautiful day on Sunday, getting into the middle 60s, but get out and enjoy it because that weather is going to change by Monday morning. Idaho Falls also with the cloudy conditions. Chance of some snow tomorrow morning. Daytime highs in the 40s, lows in the 20s, 50s by Saturday, 60s by Sunday, and then the winds will pick up. We're talking anywhere from 20 to 30, even gusts of 35 mile per hour winds by the start of the new week. Rexburg looking for cloudy conditions, chance of rain, snow mix, lows in the 20s, highs expected to be in the 40s, 50s by the end of the weekend. Teton area, cloudy conditions with chance of snow coming in Thursday and Monday. Our highs warming up to the upper 30s by Saturday, mid 40s by Sunday, lows still in the teens and 20s. And then in through the central mountains, chance of that rain, snow mix tomorrow morning, Thursday, with clouds sticking around to Friday, eventually some clearing by Saturday and Sunday, as we expect to get up into the 50s and 60s by the weekend. Deanne?